Stay till the end to learn how to get a free audiobook from Audible. Simple Life presents Dating Advice for Introvert Men. These days, a lot of guys are fairly introverted and are finding it difficult to succeed with women. They don't enjoy socializing that much or having to go to parties and try to be the center of attention to attract women. They would rather be able to simply meet a nice girl and have a relationship, without having to go out nightclubbing every weekend, or having a huge group of friends that they see every week. A lot of introverted guys are often deep thinkers and prefer to think about life and focus on other things, rather than just socializing and hanging out with people for no reason. However, these guys still want to be successful with women. You still want to be able to get a girlfriend and enjoy yourself. You don't want to have to miss out on it because you're not an extroverted guy. So, is it possible? Can you still have your choice of women and get a girlfriend, or find a wife, without having to be a wild extrovert who is addicted to being around loads of people? Definitely. While no magic wand can take your introversion away, there are some things you can do to master the art of dating. The preparation. 1. No drastic changes. Should you decide that you want some new shoes or even a new outfit for your date, go for it. But don't make big changes. Don't buy a pair of shoes or an outfit that isn't you. Don't get a brand new haircut. Here's the thing about such changes. You will spend the date being very self-conscious because you are not comfortable with such a change. You haven't had your own time to get used to it, and now you are on a date. The goal is to increase your comfort level, and dressing as you always do will help that. 2. Pick a dating event that's short. Meeting for a drink or coffee or attending some short event is usually the best for an introvert. There is comfort in knowing that it will be short up front, and you will have far less dread or stress. If thing goes well, that short chunk of time can always be extended into dinner or something else. It's much easier to approach the date this way than to plan a long evening, then try to cut it short. Actually, this is good advice for all first dates with strangers, so don't feel that you are somehow different. 3. Choose a place or event you know. Going someplace new can add to your discomfort. You won't know your way around and you'll be distracted trying to familiarize yourself with the place. If this is the short first date, choose a coffee shop, a simple restaurant, or a small bar you already know. You will be familiar with the table arrangements, the location and parking, the menu, and the people who will be serving you. All of these things will let you focus on the person you are with. 4. Pick an activity you enjoy. If sitting across from a stranger and making conversation is awkward for you, why not choose a date in which you will be actively doing something? Weather permitting, you could go to the zoo or botanical garden. You could go to a wine or food tasting event or a street fest. How about a bar that has air hockey if you're good at it? Being involved in an activity gives you more to talk about, and it allows you to be you. 5. Practice a bit. When job candidates go for interviews, they often practice answering the likely questions with a friend. A first date is a bit like an interview, let's face it. Get a friend to sit down with you and ask you some likely questions. Practice both your verbal and non-verbal responses, including facial expressions and other gestures until they seem natural. Then, turn the tables. You come up with questions to ask your date, then practice being an active good listener as well. During the date. 6. Ask open-ended questions. If you have practiced with that friend, you have questions to which there are longer answers than just yes or no. Ask them, and practice those listening skills with eye contact, head nods, and small smiles. You want that individual to know you have a genuine interest in others and in her specifically. Plus, how else do you get to know someone if you don't ask questions that allow them to open up and show you who they are? Instead of asking them what they do for a living, ask them what they like best and least about their job. Just don't keep firing those questions out of nervousness. You won't want your date to feel like it is an interrogation. If you have practiced the likely questions you will be asked, you will know what to share or not. Oversharing on a first date can be a bit awkward for the other person. Giving all of the details of your last breakup is oversharing, save it. 7. You don't need to hide your introversion. You may be able to fake an outgoingness for a short period of time, especially if you have practiced this before. However, you are really only doing that to make what you think will be a good first impression. If this first date turns into a second one, and she wants to take you to a large social event, your secret will be out. You don't have to blurt out that you are an introvert, but as you talk about your interests and hobbies, it is likely that that aspect of your personality will come out. 8. Plan your escape in advance. If you're seeing all sorts of red flags, take note. Here are just a couple. Your date's talk is all negative about other people, last relationship, boss, coworkers, etc. This is not a good sign. Your date treats a waiter or waitress badly or loses her temper when something isn't cooked just right. This isn't a kind person. Your date is a narcissist and can only talk about herself, never asking you a question. An extrovert in this situation might very well be a bit confrontational and announce that the date is over. Introverts tend to bite their tongues and endure the pain for the duration. You don't have to do this. Set up your excuses ahead of time. Have a friend text you about an hour in and have a signal to text back. Then the phone call can come that presents a situation that requires your immediate attention. Or start feeling ill and go to the restroom. When you return, explain that you are ill and really need to go. A fake excuse should be used as a last resort. If and whenever possible, it's best to be honest about things. You can bow out of the date with a simple, "I'm sorry to do this. I'm just feeling a little overwhelmed with things and would prefer to go home." In preparation for this moment, it's a good idea to drive separately to your date, as well. No need for an awkward car ride home. And afterward. 9. Don't ruminate. Introverts have amazing memories, detailed memories because they take everything in. This is both a blessing and a curse. At work, it is often a blessing because introverts observe and listen before drawing conclusions and often come up with good creative solutions. After a date, it can be a curse. Introverts tend to relive every single moment, kicking themselves because they said something stupid or because their awkwardness or anxiety was showing. Give yourself a break. You are exaggerating and focusing on your perceived bad, rather than on the many good things that probably happened. Focus on the positives of the date and what went well instead. This gives you confidence for a second date or to move on to someone else. Check out the link below for your free audiobook from Audible. If you like the video, do subscribe, like, and comment. Do hit the subscribe button and turn on the notification. Thank you for watching.